Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about an enduro touring motorcycle or an adventure motorcycle as they call it nowadays. Obviously, as you can see, it's a Honda Dominator NX650. This model has been produced between 1988 and 2002. This bike has a very long lifespan, I can say. Regarding the enduro touring section, I believe this is an ideal bike nowadays because you have a really lightweight motorcycle, 163 kilograms, with a good torquey engine. The fuel tank has 16 liters and the fuel consumption is on average 5 liters. This engine has the advantage of being air-cooled, air and oil-cooled, because when you are going on tough off-road sections, you will never have issues with overheating or water pump or radiator, in my opinion. So from this point of view, the solution is bulletproof. On enduro sections, the ground clearance of 250 millimeters helps you a lot because you will be trouble-free regarding some obstacles, logs, rocks and etc. You know, all kinds of sorts of things that can happen when you go off-road. The front suspension has a 41 millimeter section. The travel of the front suspension is of 220 millimeters. The travel on the rear suspension, it's almost 200 millimeters on the rear suspension. Also, the wheels of this motorcycle are proper enduro touring wheels. Why? Because you have a classic 17 inch wheel on the back and a proper enduro touring wheel 21 inch on the front, as it should be done. The main competitors of this motorcycle from her age are Aprilia Pegaso 650, BMW F650, Yamaha XT600. As you can see, the design of this motorcycle is inspired from the Dakar races. Obviously, this fender is not original. The original model had the fender on the wheel. But however, this solution helps us a lot when we are going through muddy sections. I'm going to leave here a few off-road sections that you will see what we can do with this motorcycle. The seat height of this motorcycle is of only 870 millimeters, which is nothing because you can ride along fairly well. Triangle that we have here, footrest, seat and handlebar, is very good, very comfortable. If you are over 1.75 meters, you will feel like home. I am 1.87 meters and I really feel like home. The long suspension travel of this motorcycle makes it very good for city driving also. Why? Because when you have a pothole, a bump, you can deal with it without having any issues. And also, the riding position is very, very compact and very nimble and agile. Exactly what you need on a city commute or what you need when you are going on, let's say, enduro sections. Not tough enduro sections, but when you go off-road. Because of the simplicity of this bike, many people chose this Honda Dominator NX650 as a long off-road traveler. You have a lot of trips in Russia, in Alaska, done with this kind of motorcycle, mainly because the technical solution of this motorcycle is very, very simple and efficient. Speaking about this, the maintenance cost for this motorcycle is very, very low. So with roughly, let's say, 600 euros, you are going to buy all the necessary parts for this motorcycle. Front and rear disc brakes, brake pads, fork seals, tires, filters, spark plugs, everything. So with 500 or 600 euros, you will be able to buy all the necessary parts in order to live up an old Honda Dominator. Gentlemen, having said that, I would like to know what is your opinion about this motorcycle. For me, I think that this motorcycle is a very good motorcycle. Why? Because even if she is an old motorcycle, you still have the capabilities, almost the capabilities that you have on a modern KTM 690 Enduro. Why? Because this is very, very light, quite agile, and obviously you don't have a lot of power, but in off-road sections you don't need a lot of power. You need a good chassis and you need a lightweight motorcycle with a good ground clearance. Having said that, till next time, my dear friends, I will tell you bye-bye.